you look at the Ottoman and early Muslim civilizations, they will rent a house very cheap. You rent on a long lease. After 20 years or so, they will convert that house using istibdal to another asset and give you ownership of that house. So through waqf and then contribution of public partnership with private partnership, I think we can do wonders. So we really need some of the services. In fact, there's something they call universal banking. And out of this universal banking, some of the services of the banks are now being done by finance houses, being done by a lot of other entities, not necessarily the bank. Why should we just be tying ourselves to the bank when we can do a lot of other services outside the banking service? So the way forward is do parallel kind of a financing, not necessarily relying on the bank. Look at how much our Islamic microfinance, which we'll be discussing later, see how much they have achieved. They don't go through the banks, but really they are doing wonders. So a lot of this, even later we'll be looking at this Canadian model of Musharak Mutabaq. It's not a banking, it's a cooperative model. But they're doing wonders in terms of housing financing. Yeah, so there are a lot of things we can do, not necessarily we tie ourselves. Banking model.
Banks, within this framework of banking model, we could not.
We could not say certain things we cannot. For example, for keeping money, okay, we need banks. For other facilities like trading, we need banks to help us facilitate offshore trading, etc. But for properties, I don't think the current banking is an answer. Yeah, it's not. There is one. You know about this TED talk? TED talk show. One guy says, the title is Lead a Simple Life. This guy is from Bangkok. He said, I went to work in Bangkok, in Thailand. He says, for 30 years I could not own a house. I became frustrated, I left the city, I went to the village. He says, 1 month I built a house which I could not own for 30 years.
I used to listen this talk.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yes. So he says, just 1 month I built a house. Very simple. Really, you just need to rent a few houses in the city. Go to the kampung, build a house. Yes. Build a house. And one thing is also is, all of you students, you can come using cooperative. You cooperate. Now in Turkey, I'm going to study another model in Turkey, which is very interesting. I'm sure many of you are familiar with reciprocal loan. You do it right in your university. You have 10 of you. This month, I lend to you. Next month, we lend to the other person. Do you do that or not? We call it kutu or what? Reciprocal loan, right. Now, these people, look at, they have now designed this reciprocal loan for housing. The more the number of the people, the shorter is the time period for them to recoup. If you're few, you have to wait, but if you're more, then you keep on getting your money quickly and getting the house quickly. And they are now involved in Turkey, And many people are owning the house, you see, owning just through this 50, 60 of your land buy a house for you. When more people come, you get your money quickly, And it keeps on, the chain keeps on continuing.
Back home, we do have that system, but not that
much. Because the income is lower. So if you have few of you with good income, then you really don't need a bank. Yes, you're right. No, you could have a trustee, a kind of a legal entity. You need to register a cooperative. So the law will be governing everybody here. That kind of a law. Yeah. So you can work it out. Okay? Good. So inshallah, then we meet on Thursday. So pick up the slides and, you know, the slides.